is.
Yeah, oh, Jesus, of course. Sorry about the stutter.
Hey, guys.
It's Arm, and just like I said in my unboxing video of Darkness Ablaze, I said I was gonna kind of go through the process of how I organize the set, because I do collect the full sets. So, first step that I've already done is I go to this app that I had downloaded called Pokelector. I don't know how well you can see that. You can't really see that well, can you? It's too bright. Let me adjust the brightness on that phone. If I can figure out how to do that. Let's see. Settings. Let's see. Display. Take that brightness down a bit. There, that should fix it. It's a very bright app, so. And it's got all the sets available from base set all the way up to the recent era sets, so you would hit that. And then, let's see. So we're doing Darkness Ablaze. And it gives you a list of all the cards. And by the way, I'm not affiliated or anything with this app or the website. I might leave this link to the site below. So it says when the set's been released, how many cards and secret rare cards there are, and how many that you've checked off that you have. It's really handy. Keeps you organized. So what I do with that is, because I put them double sides on the cards, I take how many cards there are, divide that by 9, and then divide that by 2, and that gives me how many sleeve binder pages that I want to need, which for this set I need 12, because you can't have half a page. So then I simply go through and look at the sets, and I look at, so they're organized by type. So the first type is always grass. They're also organized in these era sets. They're organized also by generation that the Pokemon premiered in. So you just go through and you look for all of the grass Pokemon in your set, and you put them up. And that's how I do it anyway. I put them in a, just by type first, and then I organize them by number, by set number, and I'll show you what that looks like in a minute. My Rowlet is trying to escape. So, probably not the most riveting video to make, but I figured it would help you guys out a little bit if you didn't. Because there are many, many, many ways to decide how to organize your cards. But if you're doing my sets and you don't know where to begin, this is a good way to begin. I actually have a friend of mine who collects Pokemon and has them not set organized, but organized by gem, and that's a valid thing. He doesn't collect necessarily sets, but he collects one of every Pokemon based on gen. Based on the generation that they came out in and stuff, so. I always, of course, have to go through the cards that I've put into sleeves. Oh, I don't know how to, okay. So those I keep separate. Generally. So, just keep going. Oh, How did the reverse holo get in there? I don't collect reverse holos. But yeah, you just keep doing this until you're out of cards for a particular thing that you're looking for. Type of Pokemon you're looking for, type you're looking for. Throw that in my extras bin. It's not exactly the most interesting thing to continue to watch. Okay, and I have to remember to occasionally look over at the phone and make sure the phone is not being dumb. And by being dumb, I'm going to sleep. Just keep going. So you could do this for any set that you want. Every set, that's what I do. And when I get enough, I have unfortunately got enough cards to really justify selling them in bulk. But that's what I do with my extras if I need to. For those of you who aren't interested, I might actually end up making a shop for them. So according to this app on the set, the first card is Butterfree V, which we don't have. So we would skip that one. The next one is VMAX Butterfree, we also don't have. So we're going Paris is the number 3. So we put Paris there. Parasect would go next. And then Carnivine. Pan Sage and Semi Sage. And Carablast is number 8, and Shulmet would be 9. And then we put them in their sleeves, in their spots. Hopefully, because the current state of the TCG is just absolutely ridiculous. It's absolutely 100% ridiculously dumb at the moment. So all the extra carrier blasts, carnivines, and others go there. So then 10 is supposed to be Excelcor, but I don't think I pulled one. I'll have to double check. So that would go, I'm going to do the back side. It would go here, not here. Here. So Excelcor would go here. Rowlet is the next one. And Rowlet goes here. And then Dartrix. This Sigurai would go behind the Pansage, which you would have to put on the front, to the front side. Bounce, sweet. So the Sigurai. Situation, then bomb sweet. We go under the combine on the Carnivine. And Steam would go next. So we would go find the Shulmet. Wimpad would go behind the Carablast. And we do not have the Glissapod, which would go here. The rest of the set, the rest of my bulk extras, which are here, and put back in the booster box. This is probably going to be a fairly long video, just because I want to make sure that everything is appropriately, like, okay, so the double hollow heatran manipulator, that I didn't realize I pulled doubles. Cool. One will be for sale. Probably will only sell it for like a couple bucks. Or a buck maybe, I don't know. I might do like a thing where I sell my bulk cards on like on a Square account or something. And you just kind of go through it and you look at it. And just keep going. But some people, they organize the entire, like, all of the tapes together and then they put them in order, but I find it more efficient to organize type at one type at a time. Okay. That trippy bun will be Earth though. I'm gonna show you. I know I showed you in the opening video, but that is a trippy bun will be card. And yeah, the Pokemon cards do tend to follow a pattern with the typing of the ball. Especially in the set, in the current sets. So I think I'm gonna do one more. One more tape, and I will go ahead and show you how I then organize the trainers. Actually, I'll just tell you that I organize the trainers by their set name or set number. So that's pretty basic. There's no, like, special, like, thing for it. It's just, you look at the bottom of the set, and then I'll show you that in a moment when I'm done with organizing the fire, or when I'm looking at the fire, when I'm done with the fires. So if you notice, the end of the bottom corner, it's the bottom left hand corner, if you're looking at the card, you can kind of see all of the set information. Let me look up and focus. You can kind of. I'm trying to get. There you go, there, it focused. So you see how it says 32 out of 189? That is how I know where the set, where the card goes in relation to the other cards. So the charger to V is 19. So let's start a new page. Oops. One page, not like three. So we got that V. Charger V, the Phoenix is next. Doom V. Don't have that. And then we have the torture and combustion. And probably the blaziken. Right? Blaziken. Hollow heat trim. Oh, I do have the Houndoom V. Okay. And then the heat trim. And then the panacea. And semi seer. How do I not have it here? I was gonna say, how do I not have a common panacea? Okay, this is it. And that is the basis for. So, when I'm done sorting and organizing, I look at how many cards I need. See how much they are. And that's another great thing that you can use this app for, is you can tell it. You can see what things are worth, or how much things are selling for. It's the Torchic, Sunnyseer, Panacea, Combustion, Pan. Okay, so. Card is when the next one starts, which is Galarian. Then we have Galarian Manitinger. Arvesta. Arvesta. Novisogum. Fair. Volcarona. Fletchender. And Talonflame. V-Max and Scorch. And this starts the mine. Glaring mines. Apparently there are two of them. Oh, right. I will actually go back and do that in a moment. I forgot to tell you guys that I also, as I'm going, I usually go in the app and I check off the Pokemon that we have, and it will update the cards. So it'll update your like total count, which is nice. So I have 11% of the cards logged, but I don't have only have 11%. Alright, well, this video is going to be really long, so I'm gonna go ahead and end it here. I'm gonna continue to do this, and I will come back later to show you what the finished product looks like. Okay. See you later on. Alright, so I've got the completed set. It took me about another hour after the first three form things I did. So they're all done. I don't know if people show the complete sets, but it's actually better to show them for educational purposes. Sets with holes in it. And I've got a lot of holes that I need to fill in. I'll probably just buy singles, which you can get. Again, I'm not affiliated or nothing with this site or with the app or anything. But, let's say, so the first set, first card in the set is, what did I say? What was it? It was the Butterfree V card. Butterfree V. So you click on that, and it gives you what sites are selling it and what they're selling it for. So TCG8 is selling it for 75 cents, which is really cheap. Or and Troll and Toad is selling it for $1.97. So you can just do that with all your cards. Figure out what you need, buy them direct to the site, directly from their sites. And that's pretty cool. And again, you can do that with any set that they have archives that people have reported stuff for. So that's my Darkness of Blaze organizing set, and this is all the filler, all the extras. I'm actually thinking, like I said, about doing a thing where I set up a temporary square shop that has the quantities of the cards and stuff like that. You guys can buy them if you want. Yeah. So hopefully this helped somebody in some way. A little bit behind the scenes. So I will see you guys next time, I guess. Thank you guys for watching. If you guys enjoyed the video, don't forget to like, comment, and if you haven't already, subscribe to the channel. And don't forget to also check out the links in the description for my Twitch and my Twitter account. If you would like to see more videos like the one you just watched, click the playlist above the numeral. And if you want to check out the video that's most recent to the channel, click the one right next to the slug mark. And I'll see you in the next one.